You might be wondering about what kind of insulation batts to fit in your home. We wanted the same thing at ecoMaster, and that's why we tested all the available batts. We wanted to provide a product that would last the test of time, something that would maintain its R value no matter how long it was installed, and that would be applicable to a range of applications. That's why we chose Autex Polyester. You'll notice I'm sitting on a bat right now. One of the beauties of this product is its loft, that is, its ability to spring back to its original shape. There are lots of other products that you can't do this with, and therefore, you don't know what R value you're going to end up with once they've been compressed. We're going to do a few more tests on this product right now and see how it performs. Sometimes people are concerned that their insulation is going to hold water. So if you've got a roof leak, for example, you might get some water on the insulation. Or if it's under floor and you've got a water leak, you certainly don't want that insulation to be like a sponge. Polyester doesn't hold water of itself. It just lets the water go straight through. Just like that. And in no time at all, it'll be pretty much dry and still retains all its shape and strength and all the other properties that it has. One of the concerns about insulation is how it behaves in a fire. Now, polyester is bonded together by heat, so all there is polyester fibres. With other bulk insulation, it's not so much the fibres that are the risk, but the glues that hold them together. With polyester, as I say, there's only the polyester fibres. Now, I've got a gas torch here, so I'm going to show you what happens to polyester in the case of a fire. As you can see, what happens to it is that it melts. And that's it. I want to show you now how to tear and cut the bat. Now, with polyester, all the fibres are lined up in one direction. What that means is that it makes it incredibly, incredibly tough in that direction and easily torn in the opposite direction. What that means is that if your bat doesn't fit exactly right this way in your joist space, you simply put it sideways and tear to the appropriate length. And keep doing that, butting them up. You get a perfect job that way. In places where you absolutely must cut the bat, that is in the direction where it's almost indestructible, then the way to do it is with a long snap blade knife. Press down hard on a surface that can be scored and cut along the polyester. You'll need to cut several times to get through it. It depends, of course, on the thickness of the bat. This is an R4 bat, so it's very thick. You'll notice that I'm getting through it. In most cases, this is not really necessary, okay, because in almost every instance, you can get by with just tearing. There we go. Oh, that's cutting a bat. I think you'll agree that tearing is easier. I think we've seen just how resilient the polyester bats are. Autex Polyester is the best product available for bulk insulation. We've sat on it. We've tried to break it. We've poured water on it, we've torched it, it's still good. That's why we use Autex Polyester.